Hi, and welcome to a Power Connectivity Solutions demo. This demo will show you how to create a client-site VPC VPN server using automation. This server will allow you to connect your local workstation to a remote Power VS workspace in IBM Cloud. The automation is created using Terraform and is hosted on IBM's GitHub repository power-vpn-server. This demo will have three stages. The first will be where we set up our prerequisites. The next will be using schematics to deploy the VPN automation. And the third will perform a connectivity test to ensure that it is working. The prerequisites consist of creating a secrets manager that stores the VPN server certificate and a cloud object storage instance that stores the VPN client configuration. Both the certificate and the configuration are created by the automation for you. Let's switch over to our workstation and then load up the Power VPN server repository. That is hosted on github.com/IBM/power-vpn-server. This repository contains not only the Terraform code, but also a user guide to be able to set up the VPN server. We'll skip straight towards the prerequisites and look for how to create our secrets manager. Okay, it says here that we can create the Secrets Manager by visiting the IBM Cloud Create Secrets Manager. Click on this link will take us directly to the catalog. The Secrets Manager for the demo will use the trial plan, but you can also use the standard plan. You can also use your own instance if you have one pre-existing. We'll name this VPN or power-vpn-demo. So we can remember what these are named, and we'll put it in the default resource group. Create that. Okay, it's created. So now I'll switch over to the IBM Cloud dashboard, which is just cloud.ibm.com, and we'll go to our resources list. And we should see the newly created Secrets Manager here. It may take a second for it to populate. Okay, there it is. And this will take a few minutes for this to provision. So while this is going, let's go create our cloud object storage. So back to our README here. Under cloud object storage, we can create the object storage by using this link here. So we'll follow that. That'll take us back again to the catalog. And we'll use the standard plan since there's no minimum. And we're going to name that Power VPN demo. And we're going to put it into our default resource group. You can use whatever resource group you want, but it's good to keep in mind to keep them all the same. When we're creating the automation, it'll look for them in that resource group. Our resource list and refresh this. And again, this may take a second to show up. There it is. Okay, and that's active. But our Secrets Manager is still provisioning. Let's see. So one thing we also need to do for the Secrets Manager is create authorization policy. And we can create this for all Secrets Manager, so we don't even have to wait for ours to complete spinning up. So let's go ahead and do that. This authorization policy is basically so that the VPN service can read the secrets that we create. So this the server certificate, it'll be able to use that. So we'll create an authorization policy, just follow this link. And we have exactly what we need to do for the setup here. So we've got a source service and a target service. The source is going to be the VPC, VPN, and the target will be our Secrets Manager. VPC. And we need a specific resource type, client for VPN. And then the target is Secrets Manager, and we want to give it the secrets reader role. authorize that. Okay, now we'll switch back over to the resource list again and see if our secrets manager has finished provisioning. It is still going. So in the meantime, what we can do is install the OpenVPN client. So to install that, we want to go to openvpn.net/clients/client. And you can select which operating system you have. We're on Windows, so we'll download the OpenVPN Connect for Windows. All right, that's done. We'll open that up. And you will need administrator privileges to install this. Okay, that's done. OpenVPN client software, agree to that. And we can just close this down now. Okay, let's go back over to our resources and see if our secrets manager has completed. It's not quite ready yet. We'll give it a few more minutes here. Give it one more chance here. Okay, it looks like it has become active. So our prerequisites are now complete and we can go start to create our VPN. So to do that, we'll start off by creating a schematics workspace. So go to schematics and then to overview. Click on create workspace. And we'll copy our URL from the repository over to the URL here. We don't need the extra query on the end there. So yeah, just the base repository, IBM/power-vpn-server. And then next, and then we'll need again, power VPN demo. And it's in the default resource group. Okay, click next, create. What this will do is it'll go download all of the Terraform code from that repository and create a workspace where we can apply it and create the resources. This will have a bunch of variables in it that we'll need to set, and we'll walk through that here in a minute. So while it's pulling that up, let's go take a look at a diagram to show you what it's going to be creating. So currently we have our workstation with our OpenVPN Connect software installed on it. What the automation will do, will create everything here in the green box. So it'll create a new VPC with a VPN server, and then it'll create a transit gateway to tie that VPN server to the Power VS workspace that it creates. And once it does that, when you connect through the VPN server, you'll be able to communicate directly to the private network that's created in the workspace here. Okay, let's go back to our schematics. Okay, that's ready for us now. So we'll also need to create an IBM API key. But let's take a look at the required variables here. So there's a bunch of variables. You can see a big list here. But one thing to look at this here is to realize that a lot of these are optional. So there's a lot of optional variables that you can set to give it a different behavior. If you want to take a look at those, they're all here, obviously, or you can take a look in the README near the bottom. Okay, so the required variables are going to be the ones at the top. So like I said earlier, the API key. But we're going to need to give it the Power Workspace location. So this is going to be the region that we want to put it in. So DAL 10, DAL 12, US South, US East, etc. We'll give it the resource group name. And this will be the resource group that our new resources are created in, but also the resource group that we use for letting it know where the secrets manager is and also the cause instance. You can have those secrets manager and cause instance in other resource groups. And if you do, you'll use the optional resource group name variables to define that. Then we'll give it the secrets manager name and our cause instance name, which is easy. We name the same thing. And then we'll use a name for the created resources that is created by this automation, like the Power Workspace, Transit Gateway, and the VPC. And that's all we need to give it. So let's go through here and start populating these. Oh, but first let's create an API key. So to do that, we can use the IAM controls. So open a new tab. And we'll go to API keys here on the left side nav. And then create API key. And we'll just name it Power VPN Demo. Just do this like that. Create. Then we can just copy that API key. We go back over here to the schematics and input that. And we'll mark that as sensitive. This API key is used by schematics to create all these resources. So if you were to use a service ID or another user's, you want to make sure that they have the appropriate access controls to create all the resources that are created by this workspace. Workspace location, we're going to add that. And we're going to use dialog 10. The resource group name, we're going to use default. Your manager name. Can you do that? Power VPN demo. Just for the cause instance name, the same thing. Power VPN. Again, for the name, we'll use the same Power VPN. And that's all we need. So once we have all the variables in there, we're going to go ahead and hit apply plan. What this will do is go ahead and tell the workspace that we want to create the resources in the automation. This will take a few minutes to apply. Okay, we're still applying. You can see creating all the resources here in the log. It'll take several minutes to complete. Okay, looks like it has completed. Yep, got all our outputs here. All right, and so we don't really care about the outputs here. We're gonna go back over to our resource list. So look at that. We should see quite a few new resources here pop up. Yep. Okay, that's all created. And if we go into our, okay, there's the workspace being created. What we're gonna do now is go look in our storage. So here, the automation will have created a new bucket for us. And that bucket will have our client configuration file in it. So I want to download that. Download object. And we'll just open that up. Ask us to import this into OpenVPN Connect. We click OK. And then click connect. We are, now we're connected. Okay, let's go back and take a look at what we've just created. The automation has created everything here in the green box. We've created our VPN server inside of our VPC, and we've got our transit gateway that connects over to Power VS Workspace, and we've connected to that from our OpenVPN Connect client. So now what we need to do is we need to create some actual resources inside the workspace that we can connect to verify the connectivity. So this is what we're going to do next. We're going to go manually create a subnet in the Power VS workspace, and we'll create an instance or a virtual machine that will be similar to creating an application server in your workspace. Okay, so back on our workstation now, we'll click back over to our resource list. So menu, then resource list. Pull up all of our Power VPN resources we've created. We can see this top one here is the workspace for Power Virtual Server. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And we'll use a subnet. Create a subnet. Let's name it Power VPN sub, and we'll give it the CIDR of 10.100.0.0. And then the gateway IP ranges, DNS server are all calculated for us. We'll click create. It's creating that subnet for us. This may take a minute. Okay, now that that's created, we'll create a virtual server instance to go inside of it. This will just be a Linux box running Red Hat. so that we can demonstrate having that network connectivity. Just name this Power VPN VM. And was one instance is all we care about. We'll give it an SSH key. This would be one that you uploaded prior to doing this. And then we can show logging into the box with that. Continue. We're going to do Linux. We're going to do Red Hat. Leave the storage as default. We're going to use an E980. And we'll leave it the default configuration. We don't need any additional storage volumes. We do not want public network. We're going to demonstrate going through the private. But we do need to attach it to our private network. So we'll select that network we just created. We'll let it automatically assign an IP address. And we'll hit finish on that. And then we'll agree. Create that virtual machine. This also may take a few minutes. Okay, the virtual server instance was created and has an IP, but it's building right now. So we're going to let it finish doing that so we can try to reach out to it. Okay, after a couple minutes, our build has completed, but we're still waiting for the health check to come online. So this could be the VM and its final stages of booting up. We'll give it another minute or so. Okay, so we've refreshed here and it still says it's in warning. The health check is in warning, but it does show that we have the operating system and our cores of memory assigned. So we're going to go ahead and try to reach out and ping it. So let's open up command prompt and ping the IP. Now we're pinging the private IP and make sure we're connected to the VPN still. Connected to the VPN. So these IPs will be on your local box, just like if you were in that workspace yourself. So hit enter. Yep, and we can see that we are able to reach out to that machine. Let's see if we SSH into it yet. Key, that's private key, and then root at the IP address. Yep, there it is. Yes. And now we've successfully SSH'd into that box, Power VPN-VM. We can see the name here is the same. And we're over that private network. If I were to turn this off, connection was automatically immediately reset. And we wouldn't be able to ping it anymore either. Yeah, same thing, no connection. Back on. Maybe take a second to pick up. Yep, there it is. Cool. So now we've verified our connection and our VPN is working as expected. Let's go back and take a look at what we've done. Okay, so take a look back at our diagram. What we've just done is we used our OpenVPN Connect client to connect to our VPN server, which routes traffic over our transit gateway over to our Power VS workspace, and we're able to talk to that subnet, including the VSI or VM that's inside of it, going through all of that networking. Thank you for watching this demo. If you have any questions or anything, feel free to open an issue up on the GitHub page. The URL again is github.com/IBM/power-VPN server. Thank you.